You can refer to your notes. You can refer to NCERT book. Okay. So keep that with you for any reference. This is not a test which we are doing. This is just a problem practice session. So feel free to refer to any equation or any formulae which you tend to forget. Okay, ninth option one, Lalita is saying, you remember magnification of an astronomical telescope when object and image both are at infinity is FO by FE. Okay. And you can quickly draw a diagram also representing the telescope. Now this is objective and this is eyepiece. Okay. Now it is astronomical telescope. So of course it will look at the faraway object. So objects are at infinity. So the image will get formed at the focus of the objective. So this is, let's say, intermediate image I1. So this distance has to be equal to FO. Okay. And the final image is getting formed at infinity. If final image is getting formed at infinity, this has to be focus of eyepiece also. So this length should be equal to FE. Fine. The separation between objective and eyepiece is 36 centimeter. So FO plus FE is given as 36, and magnification is given as 5. All right. So from here, you'll get the answer. So FO is 5 times FE. So FE will become 6. Okay. So FE is 6. So I'll just mark option 4 and move ahead. I don't need to even find out FO because FE has a unique value in all four options. And I'm getting FE as 6. Anyways, FO plus FE has to be 36, so FO becomes 30. What about 10th? Question number 10th, guys. Okay. I'll do question number 10th. See, here it talks about deviation from the prism. And it is written that it is a thin prism. Fine. So what does it mean? We know that refractive index is given as sine of A plus delta M by 2 divided by sine of A by 2. Okay. So if the prism is thin, okay, then angle A has to be very, very less. So thin prism will look like this. This is a thin prism. Okay. So angle A of the prism is very less. Okay. That is the reason why sine of the angle, I can approximate it to the angle itself. So mu will become equal to A plus delta M by A. Okay. Now this is something which, you know, if you're doing it for first time, then yes, it is not a straightforward one. But then this is being tested again and again, where they talk about dispersion or deviation from the thin prism. So when it talks about thin prism, that's how you approximate the formula. Okay. So delta becomes mu minus 1 into A. All right. So basically, deviation depends on the refractive index as well as angle of prism, like this. Okay. Now, if it is producing no deviation, okay, if it is producing no deviation, then whatever deviation this prism is creating, okay, should be countered by the other prism. So that is why it has to be kept, you know, inverted, so that this ray becomes parallel to that ray and there is no deviation. Fine. And in case there is no deviation, I can say that both of them have rotated the light by equal amount. So like, for example, the first prism has rotated the light by let's say mu 1 minus 1 into A1. So this is a deviation from the first prism. This should be equal and opposite of the deviation from the second prism. So like this you have to write. All right. Now angle of second prism, you can get by writing this equation. Mu1 minus 1 divided by mu2 minus 1 into A1. Okay. So mu1 minus 1 is 0.54, then 0.72. So 54 divided by 72 times A1. A1 is 4 degree. 4 degrees. And this is 18 threesa and this is 18 foursa. So you'll get 3 degrees. So that is why option 3 is correct over here. Okay. So other than those who have answered, any doubts on these two questions, please type in yes or no. Okay, let us move to next few questions. This one, this is an interesting question. So let us try to solve this. Take some time, no hurries. Whatever you do, do it properly and try to get somewhere. This is question number 11. Just one hint I want to give. If you displace the lens vertically, horizontal distance will not change. Okay, so let me solve now. Now the first image. Here we have focal length F1 for the first one and focal length F2 for the second one. Okay. Small d is less than both F1 and F2. Okay. So we have the parallel beam of rays coming from the left hand side. So where it will coincide or where the image will try to get formed. Image will be getting formed at the focal length, right? So somewhere at a distance of F1, let us say, this is where the image is getting formed. So this distance should be equal to F1, right? So, but then there is a second lens, okay? Because there is a second lens, actual image will not get formed there. This image, which is the image of the first lens, will behave as an object of the second lens. Okay, so in order to find the final image distance, I need to use the lens formula for the second lens. So 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F2. Okay, now V represents the final image. Okay, minus what is U? U is this distance, because I am applying lens formula for the second lens, right? And that distance will be equal to F1 minus D, okay? Because F1 is a positive quantity, focal length of a convex lens. This is equal to 1 by F2, fine. So I will get V to be equal to F2 times F1 minus D divided by F1 plus F2 minus D. Okay, now this is the final image. So maybe final image gets formed over here somewhere and this distance is given as this. Okay, but what is asked is the X coordinate. So X coordinate will be what? This, its distance from the second lens plus small d. That is the X coordinate, right? So X coordinate will be equal to V plus D. Okay. Then you'll see that X coordinate will come out to be this. Okay. Which is in the option third and fourth. Both have X coordinates. Okay. So 1 and 2, they are out of question now. So it is between 3 and 4. All right. Now you can play smart here a little bit and say that anyways, since the lens is displaced vertically, so vertical displacement of the image will happen. Y coordinate will not remain zero. So you can mark option 3 and move ahead. Okay. So that is like playing smart here and taking some risk and moving ahead. But then if you actually want to find the answer here, then you can find out like this. First of all, you have to understand that principal axis for the second lens is here somewhere, okay? And object of the second lens is on the principal axis of the first lens, because image of the first lens is the object of second. So this is the object for the second lens. Fine. Now this object, I can treat it like an extended object for the second lens. Okay, because what is the object's height? Object's height is its distance vertically from the principal axis. Okay, so I can just track where this tip of the object goes after the refraction from the second lens, and that is where the image will be. Okay, so magnification of the second lens is basically V by U. Okay, now V is this, and U is what? U is F1 minus D. So V by U becomes F2 divided by F1 plus F2 minus D. This is the magnification. Okay, this magnification should be equal to size of the image divided by delta, which is the size of the object. So height becomes equal to F2 delta divided by F1 plus F2 minus D. Okay, now this is the height from the principal axis of this second lens. Okay, but y coordinate is what? Y coordinate is distance from the first principal axis, because first principal axis, that is the principal axis of the first lens, is the x coordinate. Sorry, is the y coordinate. All right, so sorry for that. This is the height from the second principal axis. So distance from the first principal axis will be h minus delta, because delta is a distance between two principal axes. Okay, and that's how you get this as the correct option, option number three. Fine, so slightly difficult question. So if this kind of question comes in JEE Mains, I know, I hope what you have to do, you know, you have to leave this type of questions. It will just eat up your time. Okay, so this question, if something like this comes, it has to be from JEE Advanced. Okay, all right, so let us take up other questions. These two questions. So the 12th question is a single slit experiment. Okay, and the distance between the first minima on either side is nothing but the width of the central maxima. And width of the central maxima, I hope you remember, is lambda d by 2 lambda d by a. Okay, so this will be written as 2 into lambda, which is 6 into 10 raised to the power minus 7, capital D is 2, divided by a. Now a is 10 raised to the power minus 3. Okay, so you will get 2.4 mm. So question number 12, option 4 is correct. Why are you saying 2? Oh, guys, be careful. Okay, distance between the first minima on the either side, it is saying. Okay, the distance of the first minima is lambda d by a. Distance between two minimas on either side is 2 lambda d by a. Question number 13. Okay, others, what are you getting? Question number 13. Purvik retracted his message. Purvik said they will remain parallel, and he said option one is correct. See, this ray, these two rays, they are hitting the first surface along the normal, right? So they'll just go straight and then hit the other surface. Fine. You want me to do this now? Anyone got the answer? No one. Okay, Naman is telling one answer. Others? Okay, let me solve now. What is this angle of incidence? This is 60 degrees. So this is also 60 degrees. So angle of incidence is 30 degrees. Okay. Now it will bend away from the normal, right? So since prism is the denser medium, so it will bend like this. Okay, it goes like that. So this angle is, let us say, R. Okay, this is I. So I can say that 1.44 sine of I is equal to 1 into sine of R. Okay, so sine of R is equal to sine of I is what? Sine of I is sine of 30, which is half. Okay, so this is 0.72. All right, so R becomes equal to sine inverse 0.72. Okay, now the option is with respect to what angles these rays are making. Okay, so if I get to know what is this angle, then double of this angle will be the answer, yes or no? Because other ray will also come like this, same angle the other ray will also make. Okay, so double of this angle will be the answer. Now how much is this angle? If I know I and if I know R, what is that angle equal to be? If I extend this line like this, what I'll get here is that this angle is this angle. Getting it? Now this angle is nothing but R minus I. Okay, because total angle is R. Okay, and this angle is I. So this angle will become R minus I. Okay, so 2 times of R minus I is the angle between the two rays. So that will be equal to 2 times sine inverse of 0.72 minus 2 times, or let's keep 2 common, minus 30 degrees. Okay, so that is why option number 3 is correct over here. Fine. Any doubt on this question, guys? Type in yes or no quickly. I'll move to the next one.